Hello and welcome. My name's Jonathan Vita, and in this short series, we're going to look at whether you're a brain in a vat and whether you have any knowledge at all. This is based off of a short story by John Pollock. Suppose, for a moment, that we have a computer that's very, very good at creating virtual reality. So good at it that if you hook this computer up to a brain, it can give the experiences just like normal everyday life. So the computer can cause the brain to see blue, and the brain would see blue. If the brain were to see or hear a bird chirping, then the computer would be able to, through the electrodes, cause the brain to experience the sound and see the bird chirping. Now, in this scenario, this computer is so complex, it's so good at it, it can replicate anything you would experience in normal life, just like you would without the computer. So imagine if you had like some evil genius that used this computer in very malicious ways and decided he was going to put brains in vats and make them think that they were in everyday life, regular, normal person lives, but the brains are just that. They're in a vat being fed the information. It's not like the real world. It feels like the real world. So suppose this evil genius has hooked up a brain to a computer so that all of your real life experiences could be mimicked perfectly so that you couldn't tell the difference. So the computer acts kind of like your eyes and ears. Whatever you see, whatever you hear, the computer can replicate it perfectly so that you couldn't tell the difference between the two. And so now if you're thinking about how this computer could be fed like an image of, or a video, if you will, of a bird chirping, the experience wouldn't really be of a bird chirping. The experience would be of the computer feeding that information into the brain. Now, the brain couldn't tell the difference between getting it fed from the computer or really seeing a bird. But the experience would be so similar that you couldn't tell that there isn't really a bird there. Your experience isn't actually of something outside of the computer simulation. It is just a simulation. So for this, we mean that like every single moment is vivid and coherent. So unlike a dream scenario where you might have a dream that's less vivid as real life, like for me, I don't have very vivid dreams. And when I have dreams, like I can kind of tell if I'm like hyper aware in the moment that the loss of detail is pretty good reason for me to think that it's not like real life. Or that if I can fly, or if things just don't make sense, like I go through a door and then the door disappears, types of things that can happen in a dream. None of that kind of stuff would happen in this computer scenario. Every moment is vivid, just like real life, and it's coherent, just like real life. So it's not going to be like a dream. It's going to be way more realistic than a dream, any dream that you've ever had. The simulation is also supposed to be interactive, just like if you were to go into VR. It's interactive, you can press buttons. But in this, you don't need to have any special controllers. You don't need to be able to walk around a room and have it get simulated. The whole thing is done just with the computer and the brain. So if you wanted to, in the simulation, raise your hand, the computer would recognize, given what's happening with your brain, that you want to move your hand, and in the simulation, it would move your hand. And it would feel just like you would in real life. If you want to raise your hand, it doesn't feel like there's a huge delay. There would not be a huge delay in this either. You just feel like raising your hand and boom, hey, it happens because that's what you wanted to do. So the simulation does everything interactively. If you want to walk around, if you want to speak, the computer does all of it. It manages your experience so that it keeps everything coherent. If I've described a scenario that's just like real life, then it seems like you couldn't tell the difference between the two. Everything you experience now is exactly as it would be in the simulation. That is, you might think that you're not a brain in a vat, but you really are. You think you're on your phone or in front of a computer, but you're not. What's really going on is you are hooked up to a computer. You are just a brain in a vat. You don't have hands. You don't have a heart. You think your heart is beating faster right now, but it is not. You don't have a heart. You just are a brain in a vat, and the computer makes you feel like your heart is beating faster. Everything you experience right now is exactly the same as real life. Everything you experience now is happening from a computer. You are just a brain in a vat. Could you ever really tell the difference? How could you ever know? How could you ever know that you are not really just a brain in a vat? I've just said you're a brain in a vat. How do you know you're not? Everything would be the same, wouldn't it? It would feel exactly the same. You wouldn't feel or see the vat around you. You would see or feel whatever the computer gives you. And so the computer doesn't feed you your experience of seeing yourself floating in a jar. You don't need to see that at all. You can just feel like you're in your room or wherever you're watching this video. All right, let's consider an argument. So if I know I have hands, like everybody probably watching this thinks they have at least one hand, I think I know that I have hands. So if I actually do know that I have hands, then I know that I'm not just a brain in a vat floating with electrodes hooked up to me. So if I know I have hands, I'm not a handless brain in a vat. That seems pretty clear, right? If I have hands, then I'm not in the scenario where I don't have hands, right? That seems pretty straightforward. So if I know I have hands, then I know this thing that follows from that. I can't be in that scenario. I know I can't be in that scenario. But here's the thing. Here's the thing. It doesn't seem like I know I'm not a handless brain in a vat. I don't know that I'm not in that situation. It's possible, isn't it? I could be wrong about this. And if I could be wrong about it, it sounds like I just don't know. So I don't know I'm not a handless brain in a vat. But hold up. If I don't know I'm not a handless brain in a vat, then it would follow that I don't know whether I have hands or not, right? If I know I have hands, it eliminates this possibility, but I can't eliminate this possibility, premise two. So that means I don't know whether I have hands. It seems obvious that I have hands, but I can't know it. After all, even if I'm a brain in a vat, I would still think that I have a normal human body and I'm sitting down. Just like you might be thinking you have a human body and you're sitting down right now. You aren't just a brain, but it seems like you can't eliminate that scenario. You can't eliminate the possibility. So you could be wrong about it. It's not certain. You don't know. So you don't know whether you have hands. What's going wrong with this argument? What is going wrong? It seems like you would have to say that you don't know whether you have hands, but it seems like one of those things that's most obvious in life. Like, no one really doubts that they have hands if they hold them up, right? So what's going wrong with this argument? Are you going to deny the first premise or the second one? If you deny the first one, then you're basically saying, I can know that I have hands and yet not know that I am not in the scenario. It seems like they're connected so that if I have hands, there's no way I could be in that scenario. Okay, well, what about number two? I don't know I'm not a handless brain in a vat. Well, how would I be able to deny that one? It would mean that I know that I'm not a handless brain in a vat. But I could be wrong about it. So it seems like I have to admit premise two as well. What am I going to do? What am I going to do? Well, let's consider a couple different options. Really, you could be a brain in a vat, or you could be in the normal scenario. So suppose we could kind of think of these as the like good and bad case. So the good case and the bad case. In the good case, you aren't actually a brain in a vat, and your experiences that you have are actually pretty accurate. They match with the way the world is. If you think you're sitting in front of a computer, you actually are sitting in front of a computer. If you are sitting on your phone, you're actually like looking at your phone and so on. There is a phone out there, there is a computer out there, whatever. So in the good case, you aren't actually a brain in a vat. You just think that like the way that you're experiencing the world is pretty accurate. It's right. But you could be in the bad case. The bad case would be that you are really a brain in a vat and you're not in front of a computer or your phone because those things aren't there. Instead, you're in a lab where they have you hooked up in a vat to some electrodes. And so you are actually a brain in a vat, but what you're experiencing right now could be totally different. You think you're in your bedroom, you think you're in Starbucks, something like that, but really what's going on is you're in a lab somewhere in the middle of nowhere, hundreds of miles from any major city. And you didn't think that you were in that scenario, but like that's the way the world really is. And so whatever you think you're experiencing is really, really wrong. So it seems like you can't tell whether you're in the good case or the bad case. If you can't tell between the two, then what does that mean? Does that mean that you can't, like, know anything at all? Because it seems like if you can't know what you're doing in this room right now, maybe you don't know a whole lot of other things. Maybe what you thought was scientific, what you thought, like, you were raised to believe, turns out maybe all those things were false too. Maybe you've been like this for months. Maybe you've been like this for years. How could you ever know?